Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to study theorem 6.1 of chapter triangles. To understand this theorem, we should know something, some basic things that we are going to study first. Students, if two lines drawn are parallel to each other, if the lines are parallel to each other, then distance between these two lines is always equal. If two triangles, say triangle ABC and triangle PBC are drawn in these two parallel lines, then their height will be same. That is, this height, height will be same for both this triangle. For triangle ABC and triangle PBC, height is same, that is H. And base BC will be common. Students, you know the formula to find area of triangle. Area of triangle ABC can be found half into base into height. Here base is BC and height is H. In same way, area of triangle PBC is half, base is same, that is BC, and height H. So therefore we can say that if the triangles are drawn in same two parallel lines having common base, of course their height will be equal and therefore their areas are equal. That is what area of triangle ABC is equal to area of triangle PBC. This we should know. Second thing, if we draw triangle ABC, then we can draw three altitudes to any triangle. So if perpendicular drawn from the vertex A to side BC is the altitude. So we can say AD is the altitude. If AD is altitude, then BC will be the base. In the same manner, if we draw perpendicular on AC, say BE, then AC is the base and BE is the height. Same way, if we draw perpendicular to side AD, say CF. So CF is the height and AB is the base. So we can draw area of triangle by considering any base and particular height. For example, area of triangle ABC is equal to half into BC into AD, we can write here. In the same manner, we can write area of triangle ABC equal to half into AC into BE. Again, area of triangle ABC equal to half into AB into CF. So we can change the bases and accordingly height will be changing. Now one thing you understand here, that all the altitudes drawn are in the interior of the triangle because it is acute-angle triangle. But if you draw octagonal triangle, if you draw octagonal triangle, say PQR, PQR is octagonal triangle. If you want to draw altitude to QR, then it will be in the exterior of triangle PQR. To draw altitude on side QR from vertex P, we have to produce this side, say RP. RP we want to produce, and then we can draw the perpendicular, say PA. Therefore, PA will be the height. Now, what is the difference between these two cases? Here, altitude is in the interior, but here, altitude of octagonal triangle is in the exterior. If you want to find the area of this triangle PQR, then you can write an area of triangle PQR area of angle PQR is equal to half into QR. QR is the base here. QR is the base and AP is the height. So you got the difference between these two cases. These things are important or required to understand theorem 6.1. Now let us go to theorem 6.1. Dear students, consider this is triangle APQ. APQ is a triangle. Then we can draw altitude here, say QR, and therefore we can write here area of triangle APQ equals to half into base is AP into QR. Now we will draw one more triangle, that will be the obtuse angle triangle. Say PBQ. Then for area of triangle PBQ, area of triangle PBQ is equal to half into base. Base is PB and height is RQ or QR. So for both the triangle APQ and triangle PBQ, height QR is common or same. That we already have studied that height of obtuse angle triangle is always in the exterior. Okay, so let us come to now theorem 6.1. In theorem 6.1, if a line drawn parallel to one side of a triangle. Now consider here the line PQ. Line PQ is drawn parallel to side BC. Okay, if a line drawn parallel to one side of a triangle to intersect other two sides, which are the other two sides? AB and AC. To intersect other two sides in distinct points, that is point P and Q. Then this line PQ divides side AB and side AC in proportion. That is what this theorem statement. Okay. So what is given here in this statement? What is given in triangle ABC? In triangle ABC, PQ is parallel to BC. That's what PQ is parallel to BC. This is given. And what we need to prove? What we need to prove is that this side PQ divides side AB and side AC in proportion. That is in equal ratio. That is to prove is AP upon PB is equal to AQ upon QC. This is to prove. Now let's see proof of this. Before that we will construct attitudes. So construction is draw perpendicular QM. Draw perpendicular QM to side AP. Then again draw perpendicular PN to side AQ. So what we have constructed, that we will write here. Construction will write here. That is QM is perpendicular to AP and PN is perpendicular to AQ. This is what construction. Again, we will join BQ and CP. Join BQ and CP. So now let us write its proof. Now altitude of triangle APQ as well as it is altitude of triangle QPB. QPB is a obtuse angle triangle. So MQ is altitude of both these triangles. That we need to understand here. Now we will write area of triangle. Area of triangle APQ. Area of triangle APQ is equal to half into base into height. So half. Base will consider here AP. AP is a base. If AP is a base, height will be MQ. Height will be MQ. Similarly, area of triangle QPB. Area of triangle QPB is half into the base of QPB is PB. And its height is MQ. So here you can understand that MQ is a common height of both these triangles. Correct? So if you want to write ratio of these areas, if you want to write ratio of this area, we can write area of triangle APQ upon area of triangle QPB equals to half into AP into MQ. Similarly, we will write here half into PB into MQ. Now you can see here half will get cancelled and MQ will get cancelled. So half will get cancelled and MQ will get cancelled. So what is this ratio then? The ratio will write here area of triangle APQ upon area of triangle QPB equals to AP upon PB. Similarly, we will consider these triangles. Area of triangle APQ is equals to, now in APQ, half into AQ is a base. AQ is a base and height is PI. Height is PI. Now, area of triangle PQC equals to half. Base is QC. So, QC and height is same, that is PL. And therefore, area of these two triangles ratio can be written. Area of triangle APQ upon area of triangle PQC equals to half into AQ into PN, half into QC into PN. So here PN, PN will get cancelled and half will get cancelled. And therefore this area of triangle APQ upon area of triangle PQC is AQ upon QC. So we can consider this is equation number 1 and this is equation number 2. Now these two triangle QPB and triangle PQC lie in two same parallels. So triangle QPB and triangle PQC lie in same parallel lines, and therefore their height is same. Therefore, height is same. Also, their base is PQ. Also, base PQ is common. And therefore, as height is same and base is common, therefore their areas will be equal. And therefore, we can write area of triangle QPB equals to area of triangle PQC. Now just consider these two equations, equation 1 and equation 2. Here you see left hand side, APQ, APQ, and these areas are equal, and therefore we can write from this equation, from 1, 2 and 3, we can write that area of triangle APQ upon area of triangle QPB equals to area of triangle APQ upon area of triangle PQC. Area of triangle PQC from 1, 2 and 3 equations. And therefore, if these two LHS are equal, then of course RHS will be equal. And therefore, we can write AP upon PP equals to AQ upon QC. And this is what our to prove, AP upon PB is equal to AQ upon QC. Hence, proof. In next lesson, next topic, we will study theorem 6.2, which is the converse of theorem 6.1. This theorem 6.1 is also called as a basic proportionality theorem, that is BPT.